I want to go over, there should be a PowerPoint you picked up when you came in entitled Why Immigration is the Most Important Issue for Liberty-Minded Conservatives. Now, if you'll look at the first slide, I want to make sure that we all understand 50 years ago, Ted Kennedy transformed the American immigration system into one with virtually no limit. We released this report in part because it proves that it's essential to evaluate this issue if we want our core principles of limited government, individual liberty, and economic prosperity to remain. So on the first slide, you see some of the effects of Kennedy's 65 immigration reform. And the number of immigrants coming to America since that time has quadrupled since 1965. And these surveys prove that the issue is not about race or ethnicity. It's about the majority of immigrants who sincerely believe in big government. We all support the American tradition of legal immigration, but from 1776 to 1965, that tradition was about 250,000 legal immigrants per year. Today, at 1.2 million per year, that's almost five times our traditional level. On slide three, you'll see the potential impact of the Senate Gang of Eight bill. Let's note that the 17.3 million new voters it would create, only a third of them are from the amnesty, but two-thirds are from the increase in legal immigration, and that's the bulk of the problem. Our immigration study, the Blue Book, is survey after survey of immigrants saying that they want big government. As Phyllis talked about, you see on slide four, heavy majorities of immigrants prefer bigger government providing more services. And slide five goes into greater detail about the survey data showing strong support for many of the issues championed by the liberals. You know, most Republicans are reluctant to address the partisan realities of high levels of immigration, but Barack Obama and his liberal Democrats, they're not scared. And they're united over this issue, and they are quite frank about the benefits that these levels bring to building their base. There's no evidence, and let's be clear about this, there is absolutely no evidence that amnesty or inviting more immigration will produce more Republican votes. Now, allowing assimilation and integration might make them more likely to vote conservative over time, but when 1 million people are coming in every year, not to mention the illegals, we can't expect newcomers to assimilate. As Phyllis said, after the great wave of the last century, from 1930 to 1965, there were about 40 years of very low levels to allow for this assimilation. And as I say in the concluding slide, whatever your most important issue is as a conservative, it likely has no future if we continue these levels of immigration. We're changing the electorate with our immigration policy, and if you continue to change the electorate, you're eventually going to have to change your policy. So, if we want to remain a nationally competitive party, conservative Republicans face a choice. We can either lower our immigration numbers and allow America to remain uniquely exceptional, or we can change our position on every other issue in order to remain nationally competitive. So next we're going to hear from Steve Camerota, who is truly